guys. How are you? Thank you. Like, at first I was like, is everyone just going to stare at me? I kind of like these because they're super intimate and I know all of you, which is nice. And then since there are so, like, it's a small group, we get to know this next artist, which she's super up and coming. But I have a feeling that you're going to hear a lot more from her in the coming months. So please give it up for CYN. Hey.
Hello. Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Thank you.
Welcome to Texas.
Hi.
Is it windy out there?
Yeah, it is very windy.
Ugh, it's the worst. The wind is the worst kind of weather, I think. Worse than, like, rain or snow, because then you can't, like, wear lip gloss and your hair down.
Yeah.
You're just, like, eating your own hair. Or is
Absolutely.
That just me?
No, it's all of us. Definitely all of us.
Well, welcome to Texas.
Thank you.
Can we turn the radio down, John? Thank you. Because I don't want to hear myself. No. welcome to Texas. Is this your first time?
No. I've been here maybe 4 or 5 times.
Okay, cool. So yeah. What do you think?
I
Be
love
honest.
It. It's great. Okay. I mean, I don't think I've ever had the chance to, like, really get to know the city. It's kind of just come in real quick and leave after a show or something. So I don't, like, know what Dallas is like. But I've had fun.
Good. That's good. There's lots to do here. One of my favorite places, and you guys can probably speak to this too, is Deep Ellum. It's like a super grungy, artsy music scene. So if you, I'm sure you'll play a show there. Like,
maybe. Yeah.
If you haven't yet, so.
Sometimes I just forget, like, you know, when you're just, like, going through it, you're like, oh, wait, I have played that place.
Yes.
So there's a chance, but maybe not.
We'll put it on your to-do.
All right.
But we really want to get to know you. But first, let's start with a song so Great. We can kind of get to know your music first.
Sure. I'm going to hold the mic, so. This first song that I'm going to sing is called Terrible Ideas. Look at us, talking about things like we're rich enough. Book a flight, took a flight to Paris. And you look at me like, damn, I've never done this ridiculous. He's saying the craziest things before we touch. I think he might be serious. With his head between my legs, I think he's lost his. Wanna have my babies. Wanna have my last name. It's all very tempting, all that he's saying. He's got terrible ideas. Terrible ideas. Terrible ideas. Terrible ideas. He's got meticulous. No, that's something you're not, you're dangerous. It isn't right, is it right, the risk of us? I'm trying my best, my hands are tight, I can't resist. Wanna have his babies, wanna have his last name. It's all very tempting, what am I saying? I've got terrible ideas. Terrible ideas. Terrible ideas. Terrible ideas. I feel so alive. Want you faster on the 405. Not scared to die. We get off on all these. I feel so.
Awesome. That was Terrible Ideas. of your new ones, mm-hmm. which I want to talk about all your new music coming up. But let's take it back to early 2000s. You're growing up in Detroit.
Yes.
When did you know that you were musical? When did you know that music was something you wanted to pursue? How old were you?
Well, I was probably like, let's see. My parents, they divorced when I was like 3. And in that moment, I was using music to get through it. Just like watching my mom listen to Jewel's CD over and over, her first one. And then it became a cathartic experience for me as well, just watching her. And from that point on, I think as a toddler, I decided I wanted to be in music.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. I didn't know what it meant.
Right.
And
right,
I didn't
right.
have any connection.
Yes. Not long
even,
way to go.
Not until I was like, 21, did I really meet anybody that could do something, help me, you know, get to where I want to be. But I decided from a very early age that I was going to try, at least.
So your parents, when you told them about it, they're probably just like my parents, working class, 9 to 5. So when you said, hey, this is my dream, this is what I want to do, how did they react? How did that conversation go?
Well, they always knew I wanted to be in music. I never had to tell them. I think they always knew that. But I did go to college, and I have a bachelor's degree in management information systems. So I never really said to them, I'm going to do this. I just
right.
signed to Katy Perry's label, and they had to get with it.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
You know what I mean?
Yes, totally.
It's my life. So.
Well, it probably
but
helps,
very
too,
supportive.
That you have the degree. That's what my parents were like, whatever you want to do, just get that degree.
Yeah, exactly. It's nice because I guess even at my most insecure moments, I can be like, at least I have my degree. But, mm-hmm. you know, I try to stay away from that
I know.
Place.
Yes. You mentioned Katy Perry. She did play a pretty crucial role in your success so far. So how did you meet her?
We got connected through SoundCloud, actually. It's a long story. Basically, I connected with her opening DJ at the time. It was in 2011. Her DJ Skeet Skeet. I started following on Twitter, and I was 18 at the time, and I was sending him demos for like, 5 years until I was like 23. And then eventually he was like, just come out to LA, let's talk about publishing. And then that whole thing, I ended up meeting Katy and doing the artist thing. It made a lot more sense for me.
What is some of the best advice she's given you so far?
To just be myself. Sometimes she says, you're not writing songs for people only in Hollywood. Think about the people you grew up with in Michigan and the experiences you had before you got to LA, because, you know, then your music can be more relatable. And I like writing for my friends back home and for people all over. So it was all good. Anyway, yeah, that was, yeah, I've sang one song. Well, come sit down.
We've got two more.
Yeah.
Actually, okay. Speaking of, why don't you go ahead and give us another one?
Okay. Phew. Well, this next one, I'm going to explain a little because I don't always get to, you know, but this next one's called I'll Still Have Me, and I feel so thankful for this song because it's really gotten me through a lot, and I love reading the comments and the messages about it. Makes me feel like I have like a purpose, you know? Anyway, ready?
Yeah.
I broke my back 'cause I thought you would too. I'd run in circles, I thought you would too. Maybe in another life, everything worked out all right, and things that made this harder passed us by. But there's no bad dream to wake up from. No, I got it bad when it's the morning and you're all that's on my mind. If I don't have you, at least I still have me. They know I believed in us last week. If I don't have you, at least I'll still have me. And if I don't have you, at least I'll still have me.
Thinking back to when you first moved out to LA and you were writing songs, and then now working with producers, maybe other songwriters, how has your music evolved since then?
Well, I mean, the sound has changed, definitely. You kind of start thinking, what are the kind of venues I want to play? And you cross your fingers, who are the kind of people that I hope relates to my music, and then you think about both of those things and you start writing. But mostly it just comes back to being the truest you can be in the melody and what you're writing about. So I think I realized that more now on my third year of being in LA. At first I was like, oh, I have to be like this, I have to do this, I, you know, this is what my label is looking for. Now I'm like, I don't care what they think, I just want to write what's real and true to me.
That's good.
Definitely want everybody's support, but you know,
right,
what I mean. I want to please people, but I also really just want this to be a true thing for me.
I feel like it takes a lot of people to like a long time to learn that. So it's definitely a good thing that you did, because the truest, you know, music and lyrics and what's your truth definitely resonates more than somebody else's words, or you trying to be somebody who you're not.
That's right.
Speaking of your music, you recently released a couple singles, the one that you sung earlier, Terrible Ideas, mm-hmm, and then Holy Roller, which is super fun.
Thanks.
You sing that today.
Yeah, that's
okay. Okay, good.
Yeah. Of course.
What else are you working on, though? Are these going toward an EP, an
mm-hmm
album?
Yeah, right now it's thought of as an EP. I've got a lot of songs that I'd like to see the light of day, so I'm just trying to like make sense of it in my mind. But there's definitely going to be like a body of work that's coming out later this, like maybe early in the summer, later in the summer.
How do you feel singing your songs in front of like a group of people? You know, your raw lyrics.
I don't know. I like it, because I think sometimes with a full set, the drummer's so loud and whatever else, people are chatting and, you know, so now I can kind of like, you guys have to pay attention and you can't talk. Sorry. I like it. It's a great experience just seeing you guys and letting you hear all the lyrics. It means a lot.
Good.
Yeah.
I want to hear Holy Roller. I just have a couple other fun questions for you.
Mm-hmm.
Just to get to know you a little bit. First and last with CYN. So, first thing, last thing that comes to your mind. First thought when you woke up this morning?
Maybe I shouldn't have had 2 whiskeys. The time difference was like quite, it was like 2 hours, like 8:30 was 6:30, and I was like, wait a second. I thought it was later. Yeah, we lose time here. So.
Yeah. Well, you're in Texas, so tequila next time.
That's what I usually do, but I thought I shouldn't be awake anymore. So
what's the last TV show you binged?
Well, last night, binging,
or just watched
last night, I watched Aquamarine, which I thought was like
oh
the
my
perfect,
god,
like
wow, love that.
I cannot put TV on that stresses me out. Nothing that makes me think about the real state of things, I guess.
Right. Just like a little escape. And that movie is, oh my God, one of my faves.
So cute.
Growing up, I
so
know.
So cute.
First celeb crush.
Aaron Carter.
Yes.
But, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he was the OG. And then he was dating Hillary Duff for a hot minute. Remember on Lizzie McGuire? And I was like, whoa, that's
yeah,
my
that
man.
Yeah, that was really hot. My mom took me to see him. I was like super far back, but I remember doing that.
I went to an Aaron Carter meet and greet one time.
Wait.
Oh. Whoa.
I've seen him out now, and he favorited a couple of my tweets once, and I had a meltdown.
Oh my gosh.
But then I saw that he followed hundreds of thousands of people, and I was like, oh, damn it. I'm not special. But whatever.
What was the last thing you ate?
A vanilla scone with vanilla frosting.
For breakfast?
Yeah.
Oh, love that.
Yeah.
No rules in your world, I'm gathering.
Not when I'm traveling.
What was your first concert?
Jewel.
Mm, nice. Mm-hmm. And the last person you called?
My boyfriend.
Aww.
Charlie.
Do you think it's weird to call people on the phone?
In general?
Are you a texter or?
That depends. Sometimes when I want an answer right away, I call people, and then they don't answer. You know?
Yeah.
But sometimes I just send voice memos because I don't want to text.
Oh, that's smart, too. I never thought of that. Okay, let's do the last song.
All right.
That'll make sure the guitars are in tune.
All good. A music video for the song is coming out at the beginning of next month, and it's a lot of fun. I'm a cult leader in it, but it's very like Catholic vibes. So I'm wearing like a maroon cape, and yeah, I'm really excited for it to come out. So when it comes out, check it out. I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, but I came to your apartment in a car with the dead. Now I'm falling on your floor, naked in a blanket. Knock twice if you're not done yet. So I'm begging you to save me, cause my heroes are dead. And I'm asking you for water with a pill for my head. Better listen to me, I've got my hands on your neck. Twice if you're not done yet. I've been feeling higher powers when you lay with me, like a Holy Spirit all confused about who it's supposed to be. So I take a sip of something you say, let's be me, God. I'm feeling like a holy roller, like a joy in the cold. I'm feeling like a holy roller, and it's all your fault. I can't prevent for something I meant besides you. Damn, you're such an angel waking up in my bed. Listen to me, I've got my hands on your neck. Twice if you're not done yet. Hey, I've been feeling higher powers when you lay with me, like a Holy Spirit all confused about who it's supposed to be. So I take a sip of something you say, let's be me, God. Joy in the cold. I'm feeling like a holy.
check that music video out next
Please.
Month, you said?
Thank you, yeah.
Holy Roller. CYN, thank you so much for stopping by and hanging out with us and playing us some songs.
Thank you. Thanks for being here. And thank you, Lilia, for playing guitar.
My pleasure.
Crushed it. Okay, we'll do pictures. And, yeah, thanks again. One more time for CYN.
Thanks, guys.